practically mush.
It was found behind the soft palate of a murder victim. The body was in the Elk River in West Virginia.
It's Buffalo Bill, isn't it?
I'm afraid I can't tell you any more about that.
That's Jodie Foster as an FBI trainee on the trail of a serial killer in The Silence of the Lambs, a depressingly brutal thriller that I found completely lacking in redemptive quality. So I sat there thinking, why are all these talented people involved in this project? Oscar winner Jodie Foster works for an FBI boss who apparently believes that it takes one to know one, and so she pays a visit to another serial killer to track one. First, she is warned to stay clear of him.
Do not touch the glass. Do not approach the glass. You can't see nothing but soft paper. No pencils or pens. No staples or paper clips in his paper.
Both killers have cheap nicknames. The one she is looking for is nicknamed Buffalo Bill. Anthony Hopkins stars as her source of information, the frightening Dr. Hannibal, the cannibal Lecter, who likes to eat his victims' body parts.
I'm offering you a psychological profile of Buffalo Bill based on the case evidence. I'll help you catch him, Clary.
There is a sporting quality to this story that I found distasteful as Foster again visits with Hannibal the cannibal.
What is your worst memory of childhood?
Death of my father.
Tell me about it and don't lie, or I'll know.
Eventually, Silence of the Lambs degenerates into a standard Monster in the House movie as Foster catches up with Buffalo Bill in his dungeon-like home where a young woman is held captive and terrorized in a well. The horrors of female abuse are too much with us, I think, now to be trifled with anymore in the movies. We had this complaint about the picture involving Julia Roberts. I have it again here. I didn't learn a thing about serial killers from this movie. A much more honest, less exploitative film on the same subject was last year's Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer. By contrast, The Silence of the Lambs is a star-studded freak show directed by the usually enormously talented Jonathan Demme, who I think for the first time in his career has picked a surprisingly trashy project.
Well, this is a tough film to review because, of course, in terms of its subject matter, one can easily target it as you have. And also, I think that the ending doesn't really work. Once she gets into the house of Buffalo Bill, it does become standard who's behind this door, who's going to jump on me from the shadows. The first part of this film, though, Gene, is terrifically effective, partially because of the real tension, the dynamic interaction between Jodie Foster and Anthony Hopkins. It's one of the most peculiar and fascinating relationships I've seen in a movie in a long time. Hopkins is very good here. Foster is very good here. The dialogue is at a very high level of intelligence, and the movie works not perhaps in the same way as Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer, but effectively. And I think that you're really shortchanging a lot of skill and craft and art that went into this film.
You know, sometimes you say, I think you blew it on this one. I think you're being too easy on this picture in this way. He is presented, the Anthony Hopkins character, is presented as this big evil thing, and we're going down there to see them, a journey into hell and all that. And frankly, he was so pumped up, and the music was so pumped up at such a high level.
It worked for me.
Well, then you're easy, because for me, I thought, oh, come on. A guy who's truly frightening doesn't need, a huge organ playing in the background. I didn't buy it at all.
This is the movies. What did you want? A documentary, black and white, television, shoot it on videotape?
No, the reason why Henry, the Portrait of a Serial Killer works is because these people, my intuition, I don't have any first-hand knowledge, these people tend to be kind of dull.
Well, they're two different kinds of movies, and you're using one to criticize the other.
Yes, we always do that, Roger. We say better picture than the same
subject. Why can't you criticize this on its own terms instead of saying what it is?
I'm criticizing on its own terms. I didn't, wasn't compelled by anybody except, I suppose, the Jodie Foster character as a strong woman.
Come on, a great performance.
Not a great performance, a decent performance.
She's Anthony Hopkins,
I thought that was way overplayed.